ॐ नमो नारायणाय। तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ श्री गणेशाय नमः। ॐ श्री सरस्वत्यै नमः। ॐ श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। ॐ समस्त जन कल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरम्। ॐ सच्चिदानन्द रूपाय विश्वोत्पत्यादिहेतवे तापत्रय विनाशाय श्रीकृष्णाय वयं नमः। ॐ सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। हरिः ॐ। सुप्रभातम्। वी ऑल आर स्टडिंग वेरी ब्यूटिफुल टेक्स्ट उपदेश सार कंपोज्ड बाय भगवान रमण महर्षि जी। इन दिस different sets of verses, Ramana Maharshi ji is telling us the importance of every path, the every marga. But if you have noticed, then you will realize every path ultimately reaches to one very subtle level, which is called as Chintanam. Note it. No one can directly reach to Chintanam. It is the highest level of sadhana. And who can reach there? Now, we must understand, and yesterday we have discussed about it, that who can reach to that level. So one point we will see now, just to recap and focus our attention. In Karma Yoga, when actions were done for the sake of one's own pleasure, then those actions are binding. Please understand. Then that karma which we do for the gratification of our own senses, that cannot be a karma yoga, and that cannot be a spiritual path also. That means doing only karma and saying that I am doing so much karma from morning to evening and that's why I am karma yogi or somebody is karma yogi, it doesn't actually suit in that category at all. So what is important when the actions are done for the sake of that controller, that Almighty Lord. So what are we doing? We are using action as a means. Please understand, action itself is becoming now a mean towards the higher goal. So what we understand, whatever we have and whatever is our quality of this instrument, that way one should be able to choose the path. Now let me give few examples. Like Ramana Maharshiji, his quality was different, so he just sat at one place. And there was chintanam, chintanam and chintanam. Got it? So this is one person or one sort of expression of the reality. Now another is Swami Vivekananda Maharaj. Person is realized, but the instrument and the quality of the instrument is where there is an expression through action. There is expression through action. So quality of instrument makes a lot of difference. Therefore, one should able the sadhaka, the seeker should understand what is the quality of my instrument. Please understand, we must know what is the quality of my instrument. Now, I'll give you different examples because this is very important topic or subject. Now, Bhagavan has taken different avatars. See, there is an avatar which is called as Varaha avatar. It is Bhagavan Swayam. Bhagavan is complete. Bhagavan is Shad Sampatti, means Shad Bhagalakshana Sahita. And that Bhagavan is in the form of boar and is fighting with the Hiranyaksha. Now just imagine, quality of that instrument was like that. So Bhagavan chose to take up that form. Please note it. So quality of instrument should be understood. Then Bhagavan takes up another different avatar, which is a very bhayanak avatar, which is called as Nrusiha avatar. Now just see, how is this avatar? This is again a furious form of the Lord. Furious form of the Lord. And it was required to kill that demon, Hiranyakashipu. Now takes up Bhagavan a very different avatar, Vamana avatar. Oh, so cute, so beautiful, so small, and a very saumya, called as extremely pleasing. But the moment Bhagavan wants to do the action, oh, huge form came out of that Vamana. That means instrument is meant to select the right path. And that requires a understanding to select a right path. Then comes Sri Ram avatar. Now just see, Sri Ram avatar, Purushottam avatar. Purushottam avatar. Then what? Then there is nothing called as dancing around anywhere. There is only a steadiness and absolutely gambira, dhira, gambira. Then comes a Krishna avatar. Wow, what to talk of Krishna avatar? All-rounder personality. Then comes Shivji. He doesn't open his eyes. He is always in samadhi. And once he opened the eye and he just burnt down this Kamadeva. So just imagine what is the quality of that. Understand, the path is selected as per the quality of this instrument. Now you have to understand what is the quality of your instrument. Hope this is clear, very important, because we are seeing different path. Puja Gurudev says, no doubt you select one path, but combination should be used to support your higher goal. That is Puja Gurudev. So what is he doing, or what he has given all of us, that you understand that every path has a different quality and it gives a different support. So as per the requirement, you use that support, but keep your one path very firm. That is beautiful. So what we have seen now, the karma yoga leads to bhakti yoga, because unless and until you dedicate your karmas to the higher altar or to the feet of the Lord, then that karma does not become a karma yoga. And the moment the Lord comes into the picture, it starts the bhavana, called as your complete emotional touch or emotional connection with the Almighty Lord. And then we have seen how this connection can be strengthened by repeating the name of the Lord. That is the point. How are you connected? How are you connecting to that Almighty Lord? Through that name. Why through the name? Because the name is connected to Nami. So Nama and Nami are very much connected. Like if I take example, if I am looking at the screen and I see Ramji. So if I say Ram Avatar Ji, so he will say, oh, Swamiji is saying something to me. Why not any other person? Because the name is connected to the form. Please note it. Therefore, we have to strengthen our japa practice. Strengthen your japa practice. And Gurudev, Swami Chinmayanandji, has showed us, whenever he is sitting and looking at something, or there is some different activities going on, Balviha children is performing something, or some stage show is going on where he has to present there, then his mala is always with him. And then he keeps doing his japa. Please don't imagine, oh, Swamiji is also doing sadhana. That means Puja Gurudev. No. Puja Gurudev does not need, but he yadyada charati sreshtah tattadeve tarojanah yassa pramanam kurute lokastadanu vartate. So teacher has to, every moment, why only teacher? We all are, whosoever are present here, is a role model for some or other person. Yes or no? Yes, people are looking at you. And therefore, every action of yours is impressed upon their mind. Every action. So how, even if you are not doing anything, how do you put your mind towards the higher goal? That also is the art. Okay, so that is a bhakti marga. But when we have seen form, without form, no name, one chintanam. And then that is called as merging with that. What is that? Then that rusthali mana swasthata. The uttama bhakti is that where the so saha aham asmi, this complete abidance in the self. That is called as uttama bhakti. Then we have seen this path of dhyana yoga. What is it telling? Let us use two important aspects. One is mind and one is pranas. Then having used pranas, it is understood that prana as a support is very limited. Please understand, prana as a support is very limited. What is called as prana? The vital air. No doubt it makes a lot of difference. What is called as? So mind goes into layasthiti. But vinash does not happen. Note it. Vinash does not happen. So for the vinash of the mind, what is required? Ek chintanat nashametyadaha. Only one and one pointed contemplation, then only the mind completely gets destroyed. Then we have seen there what is called as destruction of the mind. So I gave you one beautiful definition. Avidyamanitvena bhasamanatvam mithyatvam. That which is just appearing but which does not have its independent existence, that itself is a mithya. So this mithyatvam of this mind, who has understood, and then there is no sort of disturbance because this person has realized the truth of this mind. Now, what is the truth of this mind? Let me focus this point, which is very important. Drushyavaritam. Drushyavaritam. Then what? Chittamatmanah. See, there is called as drushya, called as object. Then this called as mind, and this called as atma tattva. Let us be very clear about this. In this verse, there are three important aspects. One is called as drushya, which is called as object. Then this called as mind. And the third is atma tattva. Now, what is the indication given by Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi ji? This is a beautiful point. He says, drushyavaritam, when all the objects are removed from the mind, what remains? What remains? Example, when the dirt is removed from the water, what remains? Just water. So, because of the object only, that mind is mind. Without the object, the mind is Atma Tattva. Hope you can understand this and it hit you. Without the object, there is no mind. So therefore Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi says, then this mind takes the form of consciousness. Chitva darshanam, tattva darshanam. Now this chitva, chit is mind. When that mind is devoid of any object, it becomes chitva. What is called as tva? Tva means tattva. Tva means tattva. Tattva means the essence. What is essence? The essence is existence, consciousness, bliss is the essence. That means substratum. That means mind is now completely reflecting the one and one consciousness. So, hope this beautiful point comes to your mind that without the object, the mind itself is nothing but that consciousness alone. Now please understand, Bhagavan already said that if there is, we have seen, jab main tha, I told you about this beautiful phrase, jab main tha, tab wo nahi tha. Aur jab wo tha, tab main nahi tha. Now this is more clear and more correctly understood with this sort of indication by our Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi ji. So when objects are there in our mind, then our mind is completely distracted and it is not with the self at all. But when the mind is withdrawn from all the objects, then there is nothing, there is only consciousness alone. So drushyavaritam chitta atmanah tattvadarshanam chitvadarshanam tattvadarshanam. Now I will give you one more support to understand this beautiful point. Bhagavan says in Bhagavad Gita, natve vaham chatu nasam natvam neme janadipah nachaiva bhavishyamah sarve vayamatav param. See, Bhagavan is telling to Arjuna, Arjuna, what are you thinking that this person will not be there, that person will not be there, you will not be there, I will not be there? Understand, there is no time, Bhagavan is telling, when I was not there. There is no time when you were not there. And there is no time when all these kings were not there. And also there will be no time when we all will not be there. That means, what is there? Consciousness is there every time. When the objects are there, then the mind is busy in object. But when the objects are not there, what is there? Think. Then there is only a consciousness alone. So that's how sarve param, that param tattva, that eternal principle remains forever. But when drushyavaritam completely, now what happens? Vedanta says beautiful point. Who is having objects in the mind? Who is having objects in the mind? One who has satyatva buddhi about these objects. Satyatva buddhi with this padartha. Objects mean padartha. What is called as the satyatva buddhi? This object is responsible for my happiness. One who has this sort of buddhi, then objects are completely filled, or objects are occupying the space of the mind because of this satyatva buddhi. Jagati satyatva buddhi. So one who has understood the mithyatvam. So yesterday we have seen one beautiful example of a mirage water. If the mirage water is there all over the road, will you stop your car? Will you have a fear? Hope not. Yes. So, if this person who has understood the mithyatva of the world, for such person, the mind itself is now a consciousness principle. So, drushyavaritam chittam atmanah chitva darshanam tatva darshanam. So, this one must be very clear about and should able to understand completely. Let us shift to now our last path of sadhana, which is called as path of knowledge. This path of knowledge is called as path of inquiry. Now, these are the important points which are required for this path to select. Because this path is direct, but a beginner cannot start with this path. Please understand, a beginner cannot start with this path. Why? Because the requirement is the first, stability of the mind is a first requirement. Now, if somebody does not have a stability of the mind, that person cannot select this path at all. Then second important point, the mind should have sufficient purity. What is called as purity? That means predominance of sattva. The next important point is, the mind should be one-pointed. It should have this quality of one-pointedness. Then, this quality is extremely important. No fear of losing anything. No fear. So see, in case of Ramana Maharshi ji, very important to understand this example as an ideal. He just gave up everything and came out of the house and directly went to the Arunachalam. Now imagine, one who does not know ABCD of that Arunachala, who does not know ABCD that who will feed me, whatever, what will happen, how am I going to sustain? Nothing. That's called as absolute fearless mind. This mind is required where there is no fear of losing anything, anything. Then this also important aspect, that is, mind should not be too busy in worldly actions. Because if you keep doing worldly actions, what happens? Your worldly so-called as transaction occupies your mind so much. Think, how will you do a contemplation? Not possible at all. And therefore you can understand, the Rishi and Muni used to stay in the forest. Why? Because who will come there? One who is absolutely in need of some right knowledge. Not a Tom, Dick, Harry will go to the forest. And nowadays, Guruji says beautifully, he says, log humko phone karte, puchte, Swamiji, how to meditate? No, oh my God. Just imagine, where is that culture of ours where there was a Rishi Parampara, and where is this so different culture, my God. Just imagine, you will appreciate now what is happening. If you are too busy in everything, if you can't go to the ashram also, if you can't attend any of the function, I'm not talking about this pandemic situation, but actual when there is a normal situation, then what are you busy about everything? Please understand. So therefore, the mind should not be too much busy in this transactional world. That quality is required, where it can focus on the contemplation of the highest truth. It should be curious to know the highest reality. Curiosity should be there, called as jigyasu, jigyata, jigyasa. So, one beautiful example for this, Srimad Bhagavatam, when Sanakadi Rishi wanted to know the highest truth, so they went to Brahmaji. Brahmaji is there, they are the Manas Putra of Brahmaji. So, Brahmaji is a father. So, they asked Brahmaji. So, Brahmaji said, I am so busy in creation. I can't answer your question at all. And I am not having time to contemplate also. So, they invoked the Lord. And Lord appeared in Hansa form. So, there is a Hansa Gita. So, just imagine here. Brahmaji, when he is too occupied, cannot express that truth so subtle which is with that busy mind. Therefore, one who has to experience and express has to be away from this transactional activities. Must. Okay, having understood this, now Bhagavan Ramarshi says, let us start with the path of knowledge. Verse number 17. Hope it is very interesting. This it starts with a very simple sort of note, this text, but then it grows into a very called as subtle aspect and a subtle level. Now it is said, verse number 17, Manasam tu kim margane krute, Manasam tu kim margane krute, Naiva manasam marga arjava, Naiva manasam marga arjava. One point we will understand. First is, there is a first question. What is the question? Manasam tu kim. That means, what is the mind? Kim means what. So, first we have to understand, what is this? What is this mind? Okay, this point we should able to know correctly. What is the mind? First question is asked. Margane krute. So what is marga, marga, margan? Margan means search, enquiry. So after having inquired, then what is a parinama? What is called as parinama? Parinama means result, effect. The result is naiva manasam. When you correctly inquire, the result is there is no mind. We are going to explain it slowly, slowly, one by one step we are going ahead. Marga arjavat. This is how this path is direct. So, four important aspects. First, the question is asked, what is mind? So, to know what is mind, the next step is one must inquire. For the inquiry, you require right support. What is the support? The support is the first. What is the support? Now please understand. this person who will inquire, why should he inquire? Good question or not? Why should he inquire? Example, if a person who is in a village and continuously doing farming, will he spend his time that how much time it takes for a flight from Delhi to America? Will he? No. Why? Because there is no need. There is no need. So why should he? Why this farmer will inquire about it? This is a very important point. Okay. So, he who understands this point, that oh God, inquiry means there should be a need for something to be known. Unless and until we have this point in our mind that I have to realize the truth, till then I will not start inquiring. So the first level of inquiry is, now there are three important aspects. What are the three important aspects? One is called as this objects of the world. Objects of the world. The second important aspect is people of the world. And the third important aspect is situations of the world. There are three important aspects, I said, of the world: objects, people and situation. Anything else in the world? No. There are only three important aspects. Objects. Objects means everything now. And situation as well as people. Now first and foremost, inquire which of three is permanent. First inquiry. In these three different aspects, which is permanent? So we will understand there is no object which is permanent. Then we will understand there is no person who is permanently there in this world. And there is no situation which is permanent. There is no situation which is permanent. Now, nothing is permanent. Ask the question, how the mind will derive permanent happiness from any of these three? How? This is an inquiry. Okay, this is a beautiful point to understand. It's an inquiry. So what is required then? Then one has to know nature of every aspect of this world. Nature. What is the nature of the object? It is jadam. Nature of the object is jada, insentient. Okay. Then nature of the body. Nature of the body. Nature of the body is also jadam. But it is connected with that Chaitanya, and therefore it is gained. It gained this Chaitanyatva called as sentiency. But the nature of its own nature is jadam. So one must now be clear, unless and until you ask the nature of that thing, clarity does not come what is called as the object or the body or the situation. What is the situation? Situation is because of our own actions. Think about it. And situation can be changed again by our own actions. So, hope this is clear. So, everything is under a complete change. Fine. Then, one must know if everything is continuously changing, what is that which is changeless? This is the first important aspect. We must also understand, if the change is happening and we are registering this change, that means something should be changeless here to recognize the change. I think you will get it. If you are paying attention, you will understand what we are discussing. If the change is happening, then let me give an example here. If the movie is screened in the theater, then no doubt we see lot of characters, lot of different sort of movements, but all those movements are happening because there is one steady and changeless substratum to it, which is called a screen. Now, without the screen, can you project the movie? Not possible. So, your attention is now, yes, there is this changeless, and rest everything is dancing on this substratum of changeless entity. This is called as enquiry. So, I am trying to make you understand what is called as enquiry. So, manasam tu kim margane krute. This is called as enquiry. So, enquiry beautifully, he will put one by one in the next few stages or next few coming verses. But we have just focused on a path of enquiry, how enquiry begins. So, inquiry begins by knowing what is around first, and what is around and what is the nature of that which is there all around us. This is the first thing. Okay. Then important is this, which is called as chintanam in this path of direct path. In our life, also just see a beautiful point which is coming up now. If you want to earn money, think about it. Do you have to meditate on it or not? Yes. Dhyayato vishayan pungsaha sangaste shopajayate. If you don't think about it, Eka chintanam, day and night, how to earn, how to earn, how to earn, and then you become one day a millionaire or billionaire or whatever, karodpati. Why? Because you thought of it and you continuously were thinking about it. Eka chintanam. Now, this chintan word is also very fantastic. Please pay note. Now, please pay attention. If you are thinking about the form of Lord, okay, let us take up Bhagavan Krishna as a form. Now, when you are looking at Bhagavan Krishna's beautiful peacock feather, it is a part of Bhagavan or not? Yes. When you are looking at beautiful eyes of Bhagavan, is it not the part of Bhagavan or not? Yes. when you are looking at the Basuri of the Bhagavan, is it not the form, the part of that form of knot? Yes. If you are looking a beautiful mala on his neck, is it not the part of Bhagavan? Yes or no? Yes. You are looking at a pitambar, beautiful pitambar, that is called as vastram. Is it not a part of it? Now, your point of contemplation is one, but it has different aspects. Please note this point. That means even if you are thinking of anything about Krishna, you are meditating. Please note, this is very important aspect. Very important aspect. Now I'll give a different example. If you are thinking about business, see how it is. Then business is one, but all different aspects are related to it. Yes or no? That means continuously your mind is busy in different aspects of the business. That means you are meditating on business. Business is your main subject and it has different aspects. And therefore you are meditating on the business. Dhyayato vishayan punsaha. Okay. Now I will give another example to make it more clear. See, there is called as person, one who says, no, I have fallen in love now. I have fallen in love. Now you ask, why did you fall in love? No, so do you know how beautifully she sings? Now just see, singing is the aspect of that person. Do you know how well she dressed up? Dressing up is an aspect of that person. Then, do you know how beautiful hair she has? It's an aspect of her personality. That means, what is the point that is called as the object of your meditation? One is an object, but there are different aspects to it. So when you are thinking, even if about the purse of that girl, you are thinking of the girl only. Just for example. So, why? Because it is one of the aspects of that girl. Similarly, if you are thinking about the Basuri of the Bhagavan, you are thinking about Bhagavan. If you are thinking just the tilaka of the Bhagavan, you are thinking of Bhagavan. If you are thinking about the color of the Bhagavan, you are thinking of Bhagavan. Hope it is clear now. That means meditation does not mean one thought, but it is one thought with different aspect. Hope this point is clear to everyone. And this is the beauty of this path. That enquiry means not one thing. Enquiry means connected to lot of things with it. So this chintanam to be understood very correctly. So we will understand more on this path of enquiry in our next session. Till then, let us contemplate. Wherever you are, sit in a right posture. Focus your attention and check all your body parts. Hopefully, they are comfortable. Check your back and neck is straight. in one line. Your facial expressions are pleasant. Turn your attention towards own breathing. Just observe your breathing. You may count if required. Let us turn your attention to the discussion of today's session. We have seen how every path starts with grossness, but ultimate stage of that is one chintanam. In the path of karma and bhakti, there was chintanam. In the path of dhyana yoga, there is a chintanam. Now in the path of enquiry, which starts with a very beautiful aspect, which is called as search, the inquiry. This path, though it is direct, it requires sufficient preparation of this body, mind and intellect. So we have seen what is a sufficient readiness. One must be free from all worldly transactions, because if you are too busy in worldly transaction, the mind cannot be available for contemplation. There should be sufficient predominance of sattva, which gives a stability. There should be a fearlessness, no fear of losing anything. And there should be a curiosity in the mind to know the highest truth. Such person is now ready for this inquiry. How it starts? A person says, my mind is disturbing me. I am sorrowful, I am joyful, and so on. Therefore, the inquiry begins. If you say your mind is the cause of disturbance, then inquire at the first level, what is this mind? This search, one must start, one must begin. So Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi ji says, once you begin this search, you will end up knowing there is no mind. This is the direct answer of this direct path of inquiry. We have seen how the inquiry begins, knowing that what is the cause of disturbance. Then a person may say any object of the world, or any person of the world, or the situation of the world. Understand what is the nature of the object. It is jadam. It does not have that capacity to disturb you at all. Body of a person is also in the category of jada, and the situation, which is just because of my own action, if I do a right action, it also can change. So first level, this inquiry must be there. So we'll understand the cause of disturbance is not out, but cause of disturbance is something somewhere inside. If it is said or understood that it is in mind, and therefore the question is asked, what is this mind? Shanti. 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 Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. Have gratitude towards the Almighty Lord for this knowledge, as well as this beautiful moment of life. Have a gratitude for everyone around us who is responsible for what today we are here because of the contribution of everyone. Check the state of your mind. Understand that silence Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.
हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ओम नमो नारायणाय।